Hello everybody, Jonathan Rayo here with SimplifiedGuitar.com, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to play the song Unchained Melody by the Righteous Brothers. This song was suggested to me by Andre Villarreal. Thank you, Andre, for the song suggestion. If any of you would like to leave me any song suggestions, all you got to do is leave it in the comments down below, and be sure to subscribe to my channel so that you can keep up to date with all the new tutorials I come out with. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and play the song for you, and then afterwards I'm going to break it down and explain it in more detail. So let's go ahead and get started.
And time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still? I need your love. Godspeed your love to me. Lonely rivers flow to the sea, to the sea.
So I'm playing this song with the E chord family with my capo on the third fret. So that actually makes it in the key of G. Now that's how I like to sing it. You can always change that if you want. You can move this capo around and to fit the range of your voice. All right, so I'm using a very, very, very simple picking pattern for this song. Now the song is going to be six beats. I want you to think about the song as a six beat song. So we have six beats per measure and then it repeats. So if you were to count to six and then start over with one. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, like that. Now we're gonna break that in half and we're gonna have three plucks going up or going from low to high. And then we're gonna have three plucks going from high to low. So we're gonna be using our thumb for going from low to high. One, two, three. And then we're gonna use our forefinger, our pointer finger, for the three plucks coming down. From high to low, one, two, three. Now, what note you should be starting with depends on what chord you're playing. So if we're playing the E chord, the first note of that chord is gonna be the low E string, okay? So we're gonna start there with our thumb, and we're just gonna go down one string at a time, one, two, three, okay? And then we're gonna come back the other way with our forefinger, starting at the end, four, five, six, okay? One, two, three, four, five, six, like that, okay? Now coming back the other way, it really doesn't matter if you start down there at the high E string or if you start at the B string. It doesn't matter because all of those strings are part of the chord. Okay, so but it depends. You do want to start the first beat on that low E string. One, two, three, four, five, six, like that. Again, let me show you this time starting on the B string instead of the high E string. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, so both of those ways work. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Either one of those works. You can also interchange them and you can play it one way one time and another way for the other measure. Now for the A chord, when we go to A, The low E string is not part of the A chord, so you want to start that one on the A string, okay? So you're starting your thumb on the A string, 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6 in the other direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. When we go to the B chord, same thing, the low E string is not part of the B or the C sharp minor or the G sharp minor, okay? So you need to start all of those chords on the A string, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The G sharp minor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. If you would like to get the chord chart for this song, as well as watch the play-along demo in slow motion and at full speed, you can click right here to head on over to the website. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and leave me any questions or song suggestions you have in the comments down below. And I hope to see you in the next lesson. Take care. Thank you.